Hello everyone, welcome back to Farmer Simulator 22. Back on Midwest Cattle Company. I had to drag our gravity wagon back. We broke the steering on it. We got it back to the grain bins, so let me get this unloaded. We have lots to show you guys today. Next, we're going to show you a new John Deere combine. Alright, we got the John Deere 105 here. There is an optional cab. I just chose not to on this one. It's also got corn special and pinstriping option. Get this going. It does have a manual transmission. Forward reverse, you got four ranges there. Header's a little slow, but that could be on the real one too. It goes up and down slow. You get a better view without a cab. You'd surely be eating all the dust that comes around. Back in the day, they didn't always have cabs on the combines way back. It's more of a luxury. We're at the 730 John Deere out here to pull the wagon around with. Now I learned that the Kilbrows has a little weight limit to it. Alright, so we got the new crops here. Silage corn, short season soybeans, rye, millet. We're also going to adopt some silage corn after a little while. We had to start a new save for all the changes on the map, and we're back in August again. At least we can harvest our oats and wheat before they wither again. also got corn dryers added in. And you get the optional pallets of propane. That's in the Midwest Cattle Company store. Actually got pallets in here too. Feed pallet, bean meal, cracked corn, pellet pallet, corn, oats, anhydrous, propane. There's a couple trailers you can buy the whole propane and anhydrous. We're gonna add some more to the propane tanks here with just this pallet, and we got a tanker too. We're gonna see it's already taking it there. Also made some other changes. You can see the gates and the fencing is green instead of yellow now. Added in more silos. Also added dry corn to the grinding silos. We're back at the shop. We've got a tipper here. I'm just going to show you guys some of the things you can refill from in here. Got lime, seeds, road salt, mineral feed, solid fertilizer. Then we're going to grab a truck with a propane trailer and fill that up. Get this out of the way. This is trailer that comes with the Midwest Cattle Company vehicle add-on. You can actually fill up water here too from the farm shop refill. Propane and hydrous. I'm gonna go with the propane right now. Actually changed the screen for the recording so you guys can see more of what's going on. It's cutting off the bottom there and the one side. Hope that works for you guys. Now we're gonna head over to the corn dryers. You pull up about right in here to find the trigger to unload. You got the propane going in there now. Go towards the front of the dryer. You can access the production chains for dry corn. You obviously got regular corn and the propane. Got our cracked corn yet. You can use wet corn or dry corn or ground corn. Soybean meal and high moisture TMR yet. Make high moisture TMR with soybean meal and cracked corn. And so this is the first phase of the 4020 diesel. I got 4020 diesel decal on there, changed the front tires. I mean, I could have stopped there and passed it on as a 4020. We got kind of a middle stage here where I started making changes to the side of the grill and the hood, even the weights. You can see the emblems are all there, but they're actually hidden behind the panels now after widening it. I have to actually move the chrome stack there and the mufflers. This is pretty much close to a final stage. I got all the decals showing again. Still got the width. I just need to actually move the front tie rod and wheel hubs a little bit. They're still a little bit off, but I managed to move them close. I figure everybody's asking about for the 4020 when it's actually the 3020, 2510 to 3020 series. So I thought, well, I might as well try and make one out of the 3020. We're actually going to go over to the field and do some corn silage chopping. Alright, so we got the 4020 John Deere on the silage harvester. I still got the in-game sounds. I might make custom sounds for it. You can tell the hood's wider now than the 3020. I think we got everything. Yeah, it sounded like it wasn't working there for a second. So you make one change, you have to pretty much change a lot of other things. That's about the max speed of the forage harvester there, about 6 miles an hour. Starting to knock down my own corn there. Mufflers I gotta move a little bit, but I think I got the chrome stack pretty much where I want it. It looks pretty good there. Actually get out and show you, this is actually silage corn. You can see down the bottom right there. I As far as the front end going up there, it did that before I even made modifications. Also want to move that radiator cap and the fuel cap over more in line with the muffler and stack there. Yeah, pretty close to where it was on the 3020, but still not quite right. Thought about changing the rear tire size, but I might just stick what we got. Also want to get a decal on the front that was on my grandpa's 4020 and the 2520 that my uncles had put on there from a piece of forestry machinery my dad was hauling when he did a flatbed hauling. Yeah, we got the front end up in the air. I bet your squad's 4020 doesn't do that. Matter of fact, I think the overall this 4020 makes squads look like paper mache. Try that again. As long as we don't run into something there. Oop. Speaking of which. I think we're gonna have to back. Yeah, we got her now. We've run into everything else. Just gonna top this off. Get back and forth gear, I think that's where it likes it the most. Doing chopping. There we got our wagon full. We got a 4020 with the duals on it. We'll haul that with silage wagon with. Ooh. I figured I'd show you both versions. Plan on making a narrow front version of this. Alright guys, I think that's gonna do it for this time. If you enjoyed the video, new machinery, 4020 John Deere. Thanks for watching everybody, and we will see you next time.